Hi everybody, today is April 2nd, 2013. Ban Ki-moon warns of rising tensions on Korean Peninsula. UN Secretary General Ban Ki-moon has warned about tensions simmering on the Korean Peninsula, saying the crisis must be resolved through dialogue. Speaking at a news conference, he said on Tuesday that the current crisis has already gone too far. Things must begin to calm down. Dialogue and negotiations are the only way to resolve the current crisis. Interestingly, you get two different stories. This one's from Reuters. North Korea leader dials down hostile rhetoric. North Korea's leader appeared to tap down his hostile rhetoric as he threatened impending war with the United States and South Korea. In a key speech published on Tuesday that implied the isolated country was shifting its focus to development, Pyongyang has launched relentless verbal attacks and threats against the United States and South Korea since new UN sanctions punishing it for its February nuclear tests were adopted during military drills by the South and U.S. forces. But the speech delivered on Sunday by Kim Jong-un focused on how nuclear capability supported economic development, although it accused the United States of seeking to drag North Korea into an arms race in a bid to hinder its economic improvement. Then back to the Press TV report, it said earlier in the day, Pyongyang announced it would restart operations at the country's main Yongbyon nuclear complex, which was closed in 2007 as part of an international nuclear disarmament deal. This comes after the U.S. sent a guided missile destroyer to the southwestern coast of the Korean Peninsula to defend against a possible North Korean rocket launch. On Saturday, Pyongyang announced that it was in a state of war with South Korea, warning that any provocation by Seoul and Washington will trigger an all-out nuclear war. Pyongyang says henceforth the North-South relations will be entering a state of war, and all issues raised between the North and the South would be handled accordingly. The long-standing situation of the Korean Peninsula being neither at peace nor at war is finally over, said a statement issued jointly by the government, political parties, and other organizations. Pyongyang has warned that if Washington and Seoul launch a preemptive attack, the conflict will not be limited to a local war, but develop into an all-out war, a nuclear war. Now, on the North Korean political party website, where they put all their rhetoric, they have an article that's posted today, where they complain about the U.S. doing its B-2 stealth bomber practices there in South Korea. Now it says they're concerned because it was unusual that it wasn't pre-announced being part of a supposed drill that they were going to do this. And usually they announce when they're going to do drills, the United States. Operations that the bombers, when and where, the United States did not disclose to the media at this time. Very unusual operation flight information public. After the U.S. bombing exercise on the Korean Peninsula, the B-52 strategic bomber, the B-2A stealth strategic bombers practiced until the Korean Peninsula, usually internationally disclosed, Pickering want to cause war, to continue to stimulate the Republic. Extreme hostilities seems to be urgently conveyed in the night on the March 29th. Another one they posted today, because they're a day ahead of us, it says U.S. Imperialist Invasion Army, South Korean Strengths of the Crime. Interestingly, talking about some military invasion that happened back in 1957, and that would have been during the Korean War. It also talks about February 25th, 1958, the dawn of U.S. Imperialistic Invasion Army, Major Thomas James and Captain Marvin Kemp Air Force Base. And this has all been translated, so I don't know what the purpose of bringing this up. December 31st, 1959, the U.S. Imperialist Invasion Army 7th Infantry Division and part of the track day, talking about beating a 20-year-old woman, forced to strip, beaten after whole body right after whatever. I think they're trying to show how brutal the U.S. is. It says the morning of January 2nd, 1960, enlisted more than 10 tracks from the great barracks of the U.S. Imperialist Invasion Army, 7th Infantry Division, cut the hair, I think, of somebody, and then drawed and quartered a person, 21 years old. Said they were electrically shaved and completely shaved. It sounds like they were sexually harassed, etc. Another incident, January 6, 1962, more than 40 people, including the resident group living together, I suppose. Dozens of U.S. Imperialist Invasion Army committed atrocities and surrounded them, fired a gun, and two people were killed and several injured. It also says how defoliants were sprayed throughout the country by the United States and did not even tell us, mobilized by him, wearing lots of damage, disorders, and suffering. And then it says in 1999, the U.S. Secretary of Defense at a news conference, I suppose it's saying, admitted that the spraying was done in Korea and the government would decide based on legal responsibility to compensate the victims or not. There's a whole bunch of articles posted today. This other one is Time for the People Won't Load. South Korean flat out poor people. Etc. So it sounds like from those articles, North Korea is claiming to be the victim. Back to the other article, says Pyongyang has warned that if Washington and Seoul launch a preemptive attack, that the conflict would not be limited to a local war, but develop into an all-out nuclear war. Last week, North Korea said its military should be prepared to attack all U.S. bases in the Asia-Pacific region, including the U.S. mainland, Hawaii, and Guam, and South Korea. So I'll give you links to all these articles. All right, bookmark my site. I'll keep you up to date. Please stay safe, and I'll talk to you later. God bless you all. Bye.